All right, guys, so in this video, we're going to talk about promises, which are a part of the ES6 standard and an alternative to callbacks, okay? An alternative way of handling asynchronous operations. And they're called promises because while they're handling asynchronous operations, they can promise to do something when that operation is finished. And we call a promise, or we handle a promise response with a dot then, okay? So we'll say some function dot then, and then inside there is what we'll do when the promise is complete. All right, now it's a little hard to explain, so I'm gonna show you, and I'm gonna use the example that we used in the callbacks lecture. Okay, so basically this is our create post and get post using the callback. Down here we're calling create post, and basically after the post is pushed, then we're going to call our callback, and in this case it's going to be the get post function. So everything works out, it's create, and the post 3 is created, and then it's listed when we call the get post asynchronously. So we're going to replace this, or just edit it, to use promises instead of callbacks. All right, so let's go ahead and go to create post. We're going to get rid of the callback function here. We're also going to take away the callback parameter here. Now when you want to create a promise, what you want to do is just, you want to return new promise, and then inside promise we pass in a function. Now this function takes in two things. It takes in resolve and reject. So resolve is what we want to call when we're done with what we're doing. Reject we want to call if there's some kind of error that we want to throw. So what I'm going to do here is take this set timeout that we have with the post.push and cut that, and then we're going to go into this return new promise and paste it in. Now after the post.push, where we would have had the callback, we're going to say resolve instead of calling that callback. And then what we'll do is go down here, and instead of passing in get posts, we're going to get rid of that. And like I said, when we get a promise response, we handle it with dot then. And then in here we can have a function. In this case though, we're going to put in our get posts. All right, so let's go ahead and save that, and we should get the same thing. And there we go. So you can see we're getting 1, 2, and 3. So that's an alternative to callbacks. Now, like I said, if there's some kind of error that you're testing for and you want to throw that error, then you could call reject. So what I'm going to do just to mimic an error is just create a variable called error and set that to true. Actually, I'll set that to const. Okay, so we just have this error, say something with the server, and then we want to check for that error. Let's do an if else. So we'll say if, actually let's do if not error, then we want to resolve. Okay, and then if there is an error, then we want to reject. And we want to pass something in here. I'm going to pass in a message. We'll say error, and we'll just say something went wrong. Okay, so now if we go down here to catch an error, okay, when we do reject, in order to catch that, we want to add on to dot then. We want to add dot catch, like that. Okay, and then we can put a function in here. And then whatever we pass in to reject, we can get here. So let's say error, and we'll say console.log error. So now if I save and run it, after 2 seconds we get error, something went wrong. Okay, so that's how that works. And if we didn't have the catch here and saved, it's gonna say uncaught. Okay, uncaught in promise, but it's gonna still say something went wrong. But it looks much nicer if we actually catch it and do what we want with it. You could display it in the browser, you could do whatever you want with the error. And if I set the error to false, then everything should be okay. and we should get our post. There we go. All right, so that's essentially how promises work. Now, the reason I'm deciding to do the promise lecture now is because the Fetch API, which we're going to look at next, is kind of the new standard to make HTTP requests other than AJAX and XHR as we've been looking at. And the Fetch API actually returns a promise, okay? So that's how it works. So I wanted to explain what promises were before we actually get into Fetch. All right, so that's it, guys. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next lecture.